heart is a bloom, shoots up through the stony ground, but there's no room, no space to rent in this town. You're out of luck, and the reason that you had to care, the traffic is stuck, and you're not moving anywhere. You thought you found a friend to take you out of this place, someone you could lend a hand in return for grace. It's a beautiful.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Dog Days of Summer July show. It's a very, very special show for Portland on the Move. The Portland on the Move show is a show that interacts the Portland Town Tech Educational Partnership with Portland High School, as well as our town hall with our first select woman, Ms. Susan Bransfield.
Good to
Hi,
be
Susan.
Here, Dave.
It's a great day, huh?
Yeah. It's
excellent.
It's Erin Brady Day.
It surely is. And we, as we said, we have a very, very special guest and has... graced us with her presence and made time out of her busy schedule. And Miss USA, Miss Erin Brady, is here with us. And Susan, would you like to do the introductions?
I certainly would. Thank you very much. We also have with us tonight Mr. Randy Sanders. Randy is the state pageant director for Miss USA for Connecticut, as well as Indiana, Pennsylvania, and Vermont and West Virginia. You've had over 30 years of experience in pageant as an industry, and we're pleased to welcome you here tonight. Welcome.
Thank you so much.
Nice to
Thanks,
have
Randy.
You here, Randy.
Good to see you.
We also have Miss USA, who is recently crowned, and she's also known as Erin Brady here in Portland. Today we have named in Portland.
Yes, we
it
have.
It is Miss USA Erin Brady Day all day long.
That's so great.
So happy to have you here.
Thank you.
Miss USA is a 2005 graduate of Portland High School, where she was an outstanding student and an outstanding athlete. She also is a graduate from our own Central Connecticut State University here in Connecticut. And in 2010, she graduated with a degree in finance. And she's put that to very good work. And she is working as a financial accountant for Prudential before she won the pageant as Miss USA. Welcome.
Thank you very much for having me.
Awesome.
What a great day, literally.
Thanks for being here. Obviously, your financial duties are put on hold for a little bit.
They are temporarily on hold.
I can't understand why.
I know. Things have changed a bit.
I can imagine. Yeah. Things are a whirlwind.
It is a whirlwind, but a great whirlwind.
Thank you so much.
Thank you for having me.
Being here and so forth. So is it all that you thought? I know it's a lot of hard work getting to where you are now, obviously, and you've got, obviously going on to Miss Universe, and
mm-hmm.
I know you're going to do awesome there.
Thank you.
And so forth, and tell us a little bit about
what's
happening.
So the past month, I've obviously have located right now in Manhattan in Midtown, which has been a dream of mine for a long time, so now I get to live that out in style, as
mm-hmm.
I call it.
Mm-hmm.
And actually, I've had a lot of great opportunities that have come up just in this first month alone, but going forward, I'll be preparing for the Miss Universe pageant, which will be held in Moscow, Russia, and we'll be leaving on October 20th for just about 3 weeks.
Wonderful.
With 88 other girls from all over the world, so I'm looking forward to that.
So you lived in Manhattan. So you got to, have you met the Don yet?
We have, actually. The night of the pageant, we got to meet him.
Is that right?
He was actually very, very calm and very collective, and I was surprised.
What a wonderful opportunity for it was him wonderful. As well to meet you.
Yeah, it was great. Yeah, it was very great.
Tell us a little bit about what it is to be in the pageant business, Randy. What does this really mean?
Tremendous opportunity to work with young people around the country, and specifically in your states where you're assigned and is assigned to directors. So each state has its own director. In my case, I produce five of the states. But you get to meet ladies from all walks of life, literally. And sometimes they're really prepared for this journey without much help needed from myself or my crew. Other times you really need to guide them and just help them learn what it is to be in the public eye, to react to the stress of the cameras and the lights and so forth. But it's interesting because I get an opportunity to meet five new ladies every year. Wow. You never know what tomorrow is going to bring. You know, it could very well bring you a Miss USA.
How many times have your states won Miss USA?
I've had two national winners on the USA level and one national winner on the Teen USA level. Oh. In fact, Logan West is from Connecticut as well.
Yeah, we met her earlier.
Yes, and is still reigning as the current Miss Teen USA. So this is the first time in Connecticut's history, or in the USA pageant history, that Connecticut has won both of those titles. I mean, we hadn't won either one yet. Mm. So now we've won Teen USA and USA. And we're able to have them reigning for at least another few weeks, you know, together. So Connecticut is very well represented in the Miss USA business right now.
I think you got a winner here.
Absolutely.
Thank you very much.
Absolutely. From day one, when she won the state title, and I was telling her this today, I really didn't know her too well other than seeing her on stage with the other contestants until we had our first meeting. And about halfway through the meeting, she just kind of tapped my arm and said, "Excuse me, but can I just say something? Is this really happening? This is just so phenomenal." And I just could tell the sincerity in her voice that it was going to be a fantastic year.
That's great.
What kind of things are you hoping to accomplish over the next year?
You know, I think for me, I've been a role model to my sisters growing up, and I think right now the biggest thing is I don't even realize how much of an impact I've left on a lot of kids from all over the country. And I think for me, just being able to do things like I had done today, go and meet all of these young kids and let them know that you can have it all. You can be intelligent, you can be smart, you can be whomever you want as long as you're comfortable with who you are, and you can do whatever you want to do. And I think for me that's really the most rewarding piece of everything. The opportunities obviously are enormous that will come from this, but it's actually reaching out to those people that you don't even realize that's the most rewarding part of it.
Absolutely.
It's great.
And for all our viewers out there, Erin just came from Portland Park and Rec Summer Camp, where she greeted and signed autographs for all of our summer campers at the
so
Portland
cute.
High School. And I tell you, they were just in awe. And they prepared songs for you.
They did. I was so impressed.
Oh, they were
I was
great.
A little nervous going in, but they were so great.
I liked what you had to say, too, where you told the children how important it is to reach out to people and always be kind, courteous, and make sure that you recognize people. And, you know, we sometimes forget our manners, and it's so important to see a person like yourself who has achieved a great amount in a short amount of time come back to your roots and see us here in Portland and to reach out to the youngsters and impress upon them how important it is to be a gracious person in the midst of a lot of accomplishments. You can still be gracious and make sure that you get down and serve ice cream and help them understand what a wonderful place it is that you're in.
It is. It's something that, honestly, some girls have come out being 2-3 years old and have dreamt about it. And I'm lucky enough to be the one after a few years that have been honored.
Did you dream about this?
I dreamt about a lot of things. I never really thought it was feasible. And, you know, I think having come into my own and then pursuing pageantry, I think was actually the best thing for me because I wasn't influenced by anybody going into it. I kind of was who I was, and I think that really helped.
When did you decide to go into, tell us a little bit how you got to to get into
pageantry? Sure. I've always wanted to pursue modeling, and it had come up in conversation from a coworker of mine that had recommended trying pageants, and I honestly didn't know a lot about them. So I had done my research. I learned the difference between Miss America and the Miss Universe organization, and the Miss Universe organization, what's so great is it's about women empowerment, and it's about being comfortable with who you are, and it's a job. It's a business position, and you know, I had gone and was working in the corporate world, and so I said, hey, you know, I'll go for it. And after 2 years, you know, here I am as Miss USA, and it is unbelievable.
That is a dream come true.
It really is. It really is.
How does one get started? I mean, obviously there's going to be young women out
Absolutely.
There watching it. How does one get started, you know, and how you did it?
Yeah, well, you know, I had done a little bit of research, and the Miss Connecticut USA pageant is fantastic. You can get a lot of sponsors. There, you know, is a fee to be paid, but you get an interview outfit, an evening gown, and a swimsuit, and you compete in those three categories, and you compete against however many girls are running that year. And if you make it, you know, you can try from the time you're 19 to 27, so you have a little bit of a gap so that you can come back and try it again and again and again if you'd like to. So Randy here has a great pageant and a great company, and you know, it's great to work with people that you're very comfortable. You don't feel, everybody says, oh, it's catty and it's this and it's that, but no, it's about being comfortable with who you are. You meet a bunch of new women from all over the state, all over the country, if you make it to Miss USA. And it's just a really wonderful experience.
Now, where was the Miss Connecticut pageant held now?
This was actually at the Farmington Marriott when I competed, but it will be right now, I think it's at the Stanford Marriott coming up in November.
There you go.
Right.
Yeah.
And pageantassociates.com is where people can find information about the event. And we handle five states, so if you go to www.pageantassociates.com, you have an option of going to whatever state website you'd like to find out information and to actually apply online to be considered as a potential contestant.
Tell us a little bit about what happens after your Miss USA, Randy. What kinds of opportunities open up for someone that has such an accomplishment?
Oh my gosh, by winning the national title, Erin will collect business cards that many of us will be very envious over. She will have the business cards of corporate CEOs, of celebrities, of talent agencies and talent directors and so forth. And she'll meet the movers and shakers in the entertainment industry.
Okay.
And to have Donald Trump as your boss, there's a guy
kind
that can
of
pick
strange
up the phone.
To say, right?
It's kind of strange, right? But you know, I would think that if anyone in the television industry or whatever direction that Erin were to decide to go after her year as Miss USA would get a phone call from her boss and have Donald Trump give you a little recommendation. Doesn't hurt.
No, I would say that opens up many, many doors.
My previous winner, Kimberly Pressler from 1999, has had an exceptional career in television. She's still working with ESPN. She's a commentator on the Professional Bowling Association tour. And she came from a very small town in upstate New York and won the state title, then the national title, and she's made a career out of it. And it's just an exceptional lady, and I know the same will happen for Erin.
That's great.
And just to have a year dedicated, Erin, to things that I know that are very close to you. Talk a little bit about some of the things that you hope to accomplish in terms of teaching the rest of us some things.
Yeah, well, what's great about it is they have their advocate for breast and ovarian cancer, which is wonderful. So it's education and awareness on that topic. Specifically for myself, I'm really trying to work with young kids that have grown up in alcohol and substance abuse families, which is wonderful because I think being a role model to them and showing them that they don't have to fall into the same path that they've grown in is really, really important. And not a lot of people like to talk about it. So I think bringing it up and bringing it to the table and showing kids that there is something positive that can come of their lives is very important. And I'm really looking forward to being able to work with kids and to show them that.
I see a lot of leadership qualities.
Yeah, it's great. And this is kind of a great outlet to be able to do things like that because
Absolutely.
It's hard when you don't have a big platform like I have been given recently. So it's really, really great.
For sure. You know, as far as the, you know, the pageantry and it's, you know, people think it's a lot of pomp and circumstance, but it's a lot of work. And I was talking with your coach who was off camera here. I was trying to convince her to come on camera, but she threw Randy under the bus here. So
Tiffany.
Tiffany's out there, and she was great to work with, and before you got here, and your point person, and I know she worked. Tell us a little about that relationship.
Sure. So I think for me, I had competed the first year at Miss Connecticut, not really knowing a lot about the industry and about what's really involved. So it was great to get the perspective from somebody that has been involved, both competing in pageants and seeing the backside of it as well. So she was a great help to me and really just kind of let me know from A to Z what's involved and what things to do and, you know, recommendations and wardrobe and just, you know, being comfortable with who you are. It's really nice to have somebody that's experienced it firsthand that can help you.
Absolutely.
So she's been a great pleasure to work with and a great help.
Yes, and I know, thank you, Tiffany.
Thank you, Tiff. You
were instrumental in working with Mrs. B here on making this whole visit happen, and we certainly do appreciate it.
I really want to thank Tiffany as well from the pageant side of things. And if I could add to it, what Tiffany does that I really like is the fact that, you know, it's not a cookie-cutter type industry. Every one of the ladies are individuals. They have their own story to tell. They have their own background, their own personality. The biggest thing to be successful in any competition or in life in general is to have knowledge, to know about what it is you're competing for, to know as much about the event itself as possible, to be prepared mentally as well as physically, you know, for the activity. That's what Tiffany does great. That's what Erin, you know, she absorbed those ideals and she came in prepared mentally, as well as all the other attributes, great looking wardrobe, obviously beautiful face and smile and so forth.
Thank you.
But she had the mental preparation that is so important.
And as I was saying, that the leadership qualities that obviously you possess and I'm sure will be strengthened over this year. Do you have any interest in politics? Any interest in getting involved?
Here we go.
Helping.
Today may have turned the corner for her.
You know, it's really, it's so important to see young people involved and develop these qualities that, you know, frankly, we need more of. And I'm so happy to see how you have grown.
Thank you.
I remember you as a student at Portland High School, and you were outstanding at that time.
Thank you. And have
used that base to now go to this level. So any aspirations?
To be honest, I had never had, that really never crossed my mind, to be very honest.
Sure.
But again,
We have vacancies on boards and commissions. You can talk to Susan.
Well, no, she met the governor today.
It's a new world to me, and I think I will learn a lot within the next 11 months left to really springboard into whatever it is that's going to come my way. So I'm looking forward to it.
So what's next on your agenda? I mean, obviously, they have your itinerary pretty planned out here. So what's next?
Next month, I'll be traveling to the Bahamas to support the Miss Teen USA competition. So our local Miss Logan will be giving up her title to the lucky girl that gets to take her spot. And then I'll be traveling to Moscow, Russia at the end of October to compete at Miss Universe, which is fantastic. But those are probably like the two biggest things right now that I'm really, really looking forward to. Right now is a lot of preparation for Miss Universe. I have big shoes to fill because Miss USA won last year. So, no pressure.
No pressure.
No pressure. So tell us, what's your favorite food?
I love Italian food.
Okay.
And I love sushi.
Oh, okay. There you go. And Randy, what's your
steak and potatoes?
There you go.
But I love Italian as well. We had a great Italian lunch today that I got to tell you is second to none. It was fantastic.
You're my kind of guy. Meat and potatoes. There you go.
Steak and potatoes.
Straight ahead forward. So, and what's your favorite diet now?
Well, I certainly enjoy Italian food. We have a lot of great restaurants in Portland.
We do.
Yeah.
We have some very
good Italian restaurants as well as. Some American food. I think American food is great.
I
got to tell you, I love Portland. This is my first time actually in Portland.
So,
the hospitality has just been second to none. You guys have, I mean, Dave, you stood out in the rain for us for like 10 minutes.
My jacket is dripping out in the room here.
Oh
my God, it was just
you made everything happen. So.
Well, it's great. It works out, and you know, just the fact that The kids, just seeing the smiles on those kids' faces.
It made my day.
Made their day.
We'll have some awesome pictures for you.
I can't wait.
We got some great video. We're going to have some great video. Obviously, after we finish taping tonight, we're going to take you over to Portland High School. We have Mr. Michael Cleary and the band is going to be playing.
I'm so excited.
My understanding is that he prepared a song for you.
That's great.
Which is great.
I might be blushing. My face is already getting red.
Michael has been around for years. In fact, Michael, I own a music store in Portland, so I'm going to have to get you to stop by.
Absolutely.
And meet my wife. But Michael used to teach at the store, teach guitar, and he has gone on. He is a mainstay in the entertainment industry
around the
Connecticut, New York area. And we're very fortunate to have him, be the leadoff band in our summer concert series. And, Susan and the Brownstone Quorum were instrumental in getting the Brownstone Quorum summer concert series back on track. For years and years and years, there was no funding. And, we got some corporate sponsors.
Well, what a great way to get people together
so
in town.
We do have four concerts scheduled this summer. And, you're kicking off the first concert
That's
here.
So great.
So, we're so happy you came.
I'm so happy
to
I'm
Portland
here.
To say hello, and we're so proud of all your accomplishments.
Thank you,
Erin,
very much.
And we're going to be watching to see how you do.
Thank you.
This universe and so many, many things that I know you will accomplish over the next several
Thank
years.
Thank you so much.
All right, you're welcome.
We're going to take a brief commercial here, and we're going to be right back. And a few more questions for Erin, then we have to get her back over to the Portland High School. So we're live here at Portland on the Move, and we're going to be airing this show the first Tuesday in August. And a very, very special show. And fortunately, we were able to get Erin to come over to the studio. And Michelle Cobby, our Comcast coordinator, was able to accommodate our studio time. So don't go away. We'll be right back here at Portland on the Move. We are back here live at Portland on the Move, and again, with us this afternoon is Miss USA, Miss Erin Braney, and we also have Mr. Randy Sanders, who is actually the head of our pageantry for Miss Connecticut, Miss Teen USA. And again, guys, thanks so much for coming on, and I appreciate it. We downed the raindrops here a little bit in getting over here, but I know we were talking off camera, Erin, as far as, tell us a little bit about Miss Teen USA and, what it is to, you know, compete in that, and what can girls expect? And,
yeah.
You
know. So actually, we went to Las Vegas for about 2.5 weeks, mm-hmm. and it was myself and 50 other girls from all over the country. So mm-hmm. going into it, you're a little bit nervous because, again, you've never experienced this before. You've heard what it could be like, but I was very, very surprised that it was fantastic. Everybody gets to talk to each other and form these bonds because, again, you're there for such a significant amount of time. You want to befriend everybody.
Now, this is Miss
USA. Miss
USA. Teen USA.
Yes. Mm-hmm. And we got to, the first week was really about going out and traveling and, you know, doing a bunch of different things with the girls, which was awesome. Got to see a little bit of the great things that Vegas has to offer. Mm-hmm. And then the second week was really more involved with the rehearsals because, again, it is a live television show, mm-hmm. so they have to make sure that everything is perfect. You're getting involved with the Jonas Brothers and Pauly D, so you have a lot of components that you have to make sure all come together. Mm-hmm. And then we had preliminaries on Wednesday, and our interview portion was held on Tuesday before. Mm-hmm. So you had a few days to ponder how you did on Wednesday, and then, of sure. course, you had the live show on Sunday night. Mm-hmm. Which goes by in a heartbeat as your nerves are in your throat and down and in your throat.
It's all the way it is. There's no cutting and pasting. It's
all live.
And it happens quickly?
It does.
It seem to happen quickly?
It's a whirlwind.
Yeah, it's a two-hour show, but
it goes by
ladies,
very fast.
It does go by very fast. And even for those of us in the audience, it does.
Well, within 5 minutes, you go from 51 to 15.
Yeah.
And then, you know, you do your swimsuit competition and you come back and they do a commercial break. They come back and then they announce the top 10. Wow. And then from there you do your evening gown and they announce the top 5. And then you know that the infamous question's coming. So get ready. Not verbatim, but it was more or less the Supreme Court had recently passed a law stating they can give DNA tests after somebody had been prosecuted. Mm-hmm. Did I agree or disagree with that? And I agreed. Mm-hmm. But what's great is before that, they ask you a question off of your biography that you filled out before to kind of warm you up, get you a little bit more comfortable, mm-hmm. and then they really lay it on thick with the question that's
sure.
a little bit more spontaneous.
Do you remember who the judges were?
I do. We had...
They were
Nini.
Very good.
Yeah, Nini.
They selected her, so...
I would agree.
We had Christina Milian. And then we had one of the WWE girls. Uh-huh. I can't remember her. Nikki Bella. They had Mo Rocca, who was the judge that asked me my question. Betsy Johnson, who's a clothing designer. Mm-hmm. They had a football player, I believe. Larry Fitzgerald.
Okay.
Harper from The Biggest Loser, Bob mm-hmm. Harper.
Really?
Mm. Okay.
You know,
one of
really
the
is
has
variety
yeah,
of backgrounds.
A lot of backgrounds,
judges, yeah.
62-year history. Really of the Miss Universe organization and the Miss USA pageant, and it's the first reality show that was ever on television. If you think about it, pageantry would have been the leader in the reality shows that are so common today. But this really is the coming together of 51 ladies from all 50 states and the District of Columbia and the intermixing of those personalities. And it's a time for them to find out that life is kind of a team sport. Mm-hmm. You know, we worry about ourselves. We're individuals, of course, but you know, you really can't get through life without appreciating the fact that it's a team sport. There's 51 there, but only one can walk away as the winner. Mm-hmm. There's no participation trophies. There's no, you know,
right.
all year. It's a real deal. It's a competition, and it's a reality show in itself.
And again, really. The mental preparation is the biggest piece
it
because
is.
A lot
sure.
of it, you go in there, and a lot of girls, they mentally check out once they come in because you have to be comfortable with who you are because there are girls that are going to, you know, you start to analyze the gowns and, and you can psych yourself out. So it's really important from the time you walk in to just be, you've done all the prep work. So go there and be totally happy with how you've done so far.
You're obviously able to think on your feet and answer questions and handle people. How did you learn that? What was your formative years? How do you think on your feet so quickly?
I have to credit a lot of that. I waitressed for 6 years.
Oh, okay.
So I think multitasking and being you're thrown out there and you're meeting new people, whether they're pleasant to you or not, and you have to be quick on your feet. They bring up, you know, conversations, whether it be sports or hot topics in the news, and they ask your opinion on it, and you just got to be ready for everything. So,
hey, lady, my fork is dirty.
You know, exactly. So I think that actually had a lot to do with it, but I've always, I kind of came out of my shell once I got into the waitressing industry because, again, They have no sympathy for you.
No, exactly.
You just got to keep moving along. So
you talked a little bit about your gown. Now, your wardrobe. Did you pick out your wardrobe? How did you?
For the 2 weeks, you select the outfits that you would like to wear. Mm-hmm. You know, for all of your events, and then the gown. Actually, we're thankful enough. We have a sponsor that provides that for us, but we can have it designed for us if we want. We have Sherry Hill was the designer of my gown. She does a lot of prom and pageant gowns, and so I'm lucky enough to have her again for Miss Universe. So
awesome.
I'm looking forward to that too.
Is she coming up with something special for you?
That is in the works.
Ooh.
Top secret.
Top secret.
It's in the works as we speak, and we also get to do a national costume, which is great. So all of the countries get to do a costume that's representative of their country, which I'm really looking forward to.
And I know that you are, I think you're a math and physics
person. Love, yes.
I know that your high school teacher who was there earlier today told me what a good student you were.
Thank you.
So it's nice
I really liked it.
You have all these abilities from math and science to athletic abilities as well as being able to handle people. And that's certainly number one.
And he loved that you signed his yearbook.
I loved it.
That was great.
That was wonderful.
That was fantastic. Well, that's great. Again, Erin, thank you so much for coming. Randy, thank you for being part of it.
Thank you for rolling out the red carpet.
Nice to see you as well. Thank you so much. It's really nice to be home. I feel very comfortable.
Well, you feel free to come. like the sign says under the bridge, come on over.
Come on over.
Anytime you want.
Thank you.
We're going to be taking you over to the Portland High School, again, the Portland High School Auditorium. And
fantastic.
We have our first of our summer concert series with the Michael Cleary Band. And he's going to be performing a song for you. So.
I can't wait.
Anyway,
so thank you, Dave.
Thank you
so
much.
Well, hey, thank you for co-hosting with me and so forth. And that's going to do it for Portland on the Move right now. And we're going to be airing this, obviously, the first Tuesday in August. And you're going to get to see Ms. Erin and Randy and so forth. And then in between that time, and I'm sure she's going to be making more news. So for all of us here at Portland on the Move, thanks so much. And again, the Portland on the Move show airs the first Tuesday of every month from 8 to 9 live here at the Comcast studio at 199 Shunpike. And again, the Portland on the Move show is a sponsorship between the Portland Town Hall, my boss here, Portland High School, as well as our Town Tech Educational Partnership. So
great to have our students behind the camera.
They are. We want to thank Chris back there and Anthony, and we got Kevin and Steve back in the control room. And as always, thanks to Michelle Cobby, our Comcast coordinator. So from all of us here at Portland on the Move and Miss USA, thank you so much.
Thank you very much for having me. It was great.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.